Since the start of Ramadan, in the first 9 days alone, 222 people have accepted Islam from this masjid. This was not always the case in this violent area. Germantown in Philadelphia, USA, has a notorious reputation, one that manages to stain every good that comes out of the town. It is notorious for violent crimes of all sorts, but the most prominent is the incessant shootings. Although Philadelphia is synonymous with violent crimes, the rate at which it occurred in Germantown was higher compared to the surrounding areas. What changed and why? During their environment, the patrons of the masjid knew they had their work cut out for them. Whatever good they planned to achieve was always going to take some time and effort, but they didn't shy away from the challenge. In 2021, Germantown experienced one of its worst violent periods in its over three centuries history, contributing a significant part to the highest crime rate ever recorded in Philadelphia history. There were shootings and other forms of crimes virtually every other day. While the Muslim community in the town have been consistent in their effort to arrest the violent situation and achieve peace, an unforgettable event happened that would stay forever in the memory of the Ummah in Germantown Masjid. It was a wake-up call. Not that they were sleeping, but this was on a different level. In September of 2021, there was a shooting right in front of the Germantown Masjid. Although the sounds of gunshots are not strange to the people of Germantown, it is a different ball game when it is right in front of you. Several shots were fired within a short time, and it left four victims, one dead, three seriously wounded. The imam and members who were in the mosque for a program rushed out to help the wounded with their clothes soaked in blood. They did all they could to help the victims get medical aid until the police arrived.
After three people are shot, one person killed. The gunfire rang out near a place of worship, and the leader of that mosque was among the first on the scene helping the victims any way he could. Sunday night, I'm Walter Perez. The big story on Action News is the investigation just getting underway into a deadly triple shooting. It happened in Germantown this afternoon in front of a mosque. And tonight we have an exclusive interview with the imam who helped the survivors.
Initial reaction was that, you know, Sunday is one of the busiest days for us. We have hundreds of attendees of our mosque in the area. So possibly it could have been a woman or it could have been a child.
Imam Hassan Abdi says he was in a neighboring bookstore when he heard the gunshots. He and other Good Samaritans rushed to the scene and helped load the victims into private cars.
It was a human being and they were laying on the floor, so we tried to get them the help, you know, that we were able to give and trying to get them to the hospital.
Shootings like that continued. And in December 2021, another one happened. And the Muslim community have had enough this time. In a nighttime shooting, 87 shots were fired, leaving several people wounded. Sleep eluded many, and first thing in the morning, it was the talk of the town. The people have had enough, but they had little to no choice. The Muslim community came to the forefront of efforts to bring peace to the community.
Police say a group of people were standing at the corner when this white van pulled up and six people got out, shooting at the group on the corner. Several members of the group returned fire. The initial shooters got back in the van, which was last seen traveling westbound on Germantown Avenue, with a rack on the roof and distinctive graffiti on the passenger side. Today, members from Germantown Mosque stood in solidarity, fed up with the gun violence in their neighborhood.
No doubt, it's alarming. And it appears to be more like a war zone.
It's been a violent year with a record number of homicides.
We're not standing for this nonsense. You know, you have Muslim daycares over here. You have the bike shop across the street that's been here for years. These people want peace and they want security in their neighborhoods. They want peace and they want security in their neighborhoods. We're not standing for this nonsense. It's sad. It's a shame that we have to deal with this. Our children, their lives is at jeopardy. We have a bullet that went through a daycare across the street. We're here to establish security in our neighborhood. not just for the Muslims, but all of our neighbors. Germantown Avenue and all the city of Philadelphia. We have to stand for something.
Since then, Germantown Masjid intensified their efforts to rid the town of violence and the fear that comes with it. They have purchased abandoned buildings that housed criminals and turned them into business outlets or for community use.
Following some advice of the Imam Hassan Somali and some of the elders in the community, we purchased another building here on Germantown Avenue, one of the buildings that, you know, harbored a lot of nonsense and, you know, a lot of the young kids grouping up here in the community. You know, we decided to get this Chinese store along with a few of the other buildings on the avenue here. So, you know, inshallah ta'ala, the building will be a benefit to the community in the future, the near future, inshallah ta'ala.
Ramadan 2024 started, and to consolidate on their efforts over the years, the Germantown Masjid intensified its da'wah outreach, and the results are simply outstanding. Scores of people have been taking the Shahada daily and became Muslims. Violent individuals are renouncing their violent ways, choosing peace instead. Since the start of Ramadan, in the first 9 days alone, 222 people have become new Muslims as the Muslim community continues to grow in the community. This is amidst other profound efforts to preach a new way of life, a new ideology to the community, far from the violence they have become accustomed to.
Like one Germantown mosque that, after a deadly shooting, hired private security, bought property, and opened business.